The little bird from this fable of our childhood is struggling with a hunter of a different kind. As the concrete jungle spreads its wings, the homely sparrow has taken a final flight, only to never come back. Driven out of the cities, severing a 10,000-year-old relationship with humanity, sparrows have little hope, save the attempts of one man in Nasik. Mohammed Dilawar, an ecologist and conservationist who trails his beloved bird in the city.
The sparrows, they require an environment where they come in constant interaction with human beings. And most of its ecological needs are being taken care by human beings, the nesting, feeding and other things. Apart from this, in an urban environment today, there is a lot of degradation, there is a lot of habitat destruction which is going on. And it is not only affecting sparrows but a lot of other species. Now, in terms like the layman would not be knowing all the common species of birds, but they all know sparrows. So by conserving sparrows, we would be conserving the entire urban flora and fauna in a way. If we can't save a sparrow which is found in and around us, it's too ambitious to save a tiger.
A laborious walk around the city, calculated study of the bird's nesting and living pattern, has helped Dilawar come up with what he calls sparrow senses.
Now if you look at this whole structure, all the nooks and crevices that you see, the cavities that you are seeing in the brick wall, as well as the one that you are the tiled roof, those are the places exactly where the sparrows like to nest. But in the new structures, the matchbox shaped buildings, there is little or no place for the sparrows to make a nest.
Into its sixth year, Dilawar's Save the Sparrows campaign has traveled a modest length. But help for the little bird is still not forthcoming.
Conservation of sparrow, even today, is a big thing. Money doesn't come in easily. So we initiated the campaign in such a way that not only we directly do something which will help in conservation of sparrows, but would also emotionally attach the people, the common man, so they come forward to play active role into conservation. So keeping all these aspects in mind, we initiated a very unique initiative which was adopting nest boxes and bird feeders.
His Nature Forever Society manufactures these nests and bird feeders locally. Till date, 52,000 feeders and a few thousand nests have been adopted, and the demand just keeps growing.
Nest boxes are surrogate cavities in which sparrows can make a nest, raise their young ones in a safe environment. In making this wooden nest boxes, 100% recycled wood is used, so we don't cut any trees because it would defeat our purpose of conservation if we use virgin wood to make our nest boxes.
The little bird has another reason to chirrup. Thanks to Dilawar's efforts, March 20th is now celebrated as World Sparrow Day.
It's a good feeling that in a place, in a time when the sparrows are really declining, and in a lot of places where there are no sparrows, in and around my house at least I have so many sparrows. Like, see, when we started this thing 6 years back, one of the most important thing was how would I be able to convince my family to save sparrows. Because until unless I was able to convince them, it's no point out and going to people to tell to save sparrows.
अभी जैसे मेरे घर में छोटा बच्चा है तो आज मैं उसको स्पैरो बता सकती हूँ कि ये स्पैरो है, लेकिन अगर यही हम लोग जो अभी कर रहे हैं, अगर हर लोगों ने थोड़ा भी सपोर्ट किया है तो उनके कमिंग जनरेशन के बच्चों को एटलीस्ट वो बता सकते हैं कि इसको स्पैरो कहते हैं, नहीं तो क्या है, स्पैरो सिर्फ कहानियों में ही रह जाएगा।
And through this medium, I would again request everyone to come forward and save our sparrows, save the birds and other flora and fauna which are found in and around human habitation. Because one, we have to take care of our nature if we have to survive on the earth.